Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here with Minecraft. If you enjoyed this video, please tell your mum to subscribe to me, and if she says no, roll back your shoulders, put a pair of brass knuckles on, and then tell her that's perfectly okay because we respect our mothers, as this really helps spread the good word of my channel. Welcome to my Christian Minecraft server. It's a survival island with limited resources, and where my mate Stealtho Carbo and I will have to work hard to try and make a life for ourselves. I'm Adam and he's Eve, like the story from the Bible. I mean, if you're not role-playing biblical love stories about repopulating the earth with your bro, are you really even bros? I'm going to be honest, he do be looking good. Little ponytail hanging effortlessly over the left chiseled shoulder, I wouldn't mind bending her over the crafting table. Anyway, it's time to grind. When a woman gives birth to a child, the pain is apparently so great they can almost imagine what a guy feels like when he dies in his hardcore Minecraft server. Being resourceful and playing it smart will be crucial in order for us to survive. I decide to collect some sand, but accidentally collapse a significant portion of the beachfront. My bad. It seems as if the natural infrastructure of this island isn't sound. But who said this game was easy? I manage to find some coal underwater, but then spot some sort of underground water temple. Carbo warns me not to get too close because there are guardians who will attack me, but I'm no Eve simp. All of a sudden, this strange beast clings onto my face and infects me with a disease or spell, who knows. I proceed to not social distance and walk right up to Carbo, infecting him as well, because if I'm going down, I'm taking the big girl with me. The repercussions of the spell have meant we can't actually mine any blocks, not even leaves, which sucks as it's sort of a big part of the gameplay experience. As we won't be able to build a shelter before nightfall comes, I decide to explore the island and there really isn't much to work with here. Fortunately, there are other islands around, so we could always invade and eat the locals or whatever, inhabit them peacefully. I proceed to eat something that smells like fish. As in a literal fish, get your mind out of the nether. Sure enough, with nightfall comes monsters, and we're forced to spend what should have been our first romantic night together killing zombies, who I admit are pretty cute. But I'd only ever go to fourth base with one if they had a gold chest plate or something. We do have a small amount of wood, so I decide to at least build the rough framework of our ocean villa, and yet again the ground collapses. I guess I've already forgotten the key characteristics of sand, but at least the curse has worn off. Finally, I can chop wood again, but then I see Carbo coercing with a zombie, and oh my god, a gold chest plate. Honestly, I've never been this turned on in my entire life. Unfortunately, I have to slay the cutie because God's watching, but in another reality, I think she could be my meta Eve. I give the chest plate to Carbo and ask him to make zombie noises for our educational reasons, and we move on with the grand plan that you'll shortly see. I've got to admit, he's pretty brave slaying all these creepers. But on a more serious note, I think I need to talk to my psychologist about how I keep having intimate thoughts involving insentient low-pixel Minecraft mobs. I can't be the only one. We fetch ourselves some lunch, and I don't know how you all fish, but here in Australia, we just jump into the water with a sword. Stealtho Carbo was once on a fishing trip with his dad, aka by himself, and he saw a 900-pound tuna fish swimming right at him, so he just jumped into the water and stabbed the Gilly Malacca with a rune scimitar. He brought it back to the local village and traded it for a woman who he's now been married to for 25 glorious years. It's a true story, I was that tuna fish. As we're about to begin our grand project, a sheep finally spawns on the island, which is crucial because we need wool for our beds. I slay the beast, which I know is impressive, but instead of Carbo applauding me, the cranky prude gets mad because he wanted to shear it so we could have an endless supply of wool. Guess we won't be repopulating the earth tonight then. I get busy clearing the top section of the mountain so we have a foundation to build our project on. It's at this moment Carbo tells me that he's going to commit the sin of all sins, and I'm not talking about premarital secret handshakes. He's going to eat the damn apple. When I became a YouTuber, I knew there'd be tough moments in my internet career, but I could have never imagined that one of my closest mates would commit literally the OG sin in front of my very eyeballs. This makes adultery look like a cheeky lunchtime bathroom fap, and then he goes on to kill another sheep. Carbo is off the rails, and I ask that you all keep him in your thoughts and prayers during this difficult time. Now, lads and lasses, it's time to build like we've never built before. I know a group of people that are attempting to build a one-to-one scale Earth. Literally planet Earth to scale in Minecraft. Which is impressive, but doesn't even enter the conversation compared to what we're about to construct. When Mojang built this game, I don't think they were fully ready for the true talent Carbo and I have. This is modern architecture on a level you've never seen before. As I head down to our camp to melt some sand into glass, a skeleton attacks me. Being the wannabe alpha Chad all gamers are, I take the fight, which proves to be the most questionable choice I've made in recent years.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine, when you're not really fine.
I then surprisingly respawn and realize that survival mode is an entirely different thing to hardcore mode. Well, I certainly feel emasculated, but I'm also happy because that would have been a pretty short video. Through rain, hail, and shine, we continue construction. We build rooftops, kill innocent sea turtles, Carbo makes two cows fall in love with each other, and then mate so we have an infinite food source. He seemed to enjoy this process a bit too much. We plant flowers and finally added an altar by putting concrete mix down and pouring water all over it. In a way, we hydrated the altar, and when you stand back, it looks so beautiful. This is officially the best Christian Minecraft server that's ever existed, and I don't want to hear anybody say otherwise. Now it's time to be pioneers and see what else this interesting world has to offer. I build a boat, insert Noah's Ark reference here. Of course, my boat isn't as big as Noah's, but that doesn't mean this boat couldn't satisfy a hot zombie woman wearing a gold chestplate. Alright, so when I record my videos, I usually divide the sessions into segments. And this time, one of the segments got corrupted, which would normally be really bad. Fortunately, as this is a top 10 anime crossover between Stealthocarbohydrates and I ask him to send me his footage. So we are now looking at the world through his eyes, which is weird, as I'm looking at myself. I'm literally jumping into the boat and sensually wrapping my legs around my own waist for safety reasons. This video is getting multi-layered and really deep. Or you know, I just need to upgrade my outdated recording setup, depends which way you look at it. I guess we also conform to gender stereotypes, as I the man do all the rowing while Carbo enjoys the view. It's a pretty interesting landscape, and it doesn't take long before we find some kind of ruins. I proceed to run over and take all the loot for myself while Carbo gathers sugarcane so our settlement can thrive back at home. I'm going to be honest, he is carrying the team incredibly hard today. He may be significantly better at Minecraft than me, but how good do I look in this enchanted gold armor I found? Your boy sure can pull off shiny purple armor, don't at me. Carbo runs over excited to check the chest out, but to his disappointment I've greedily taken every single item for myself. He then mines this sand away and proceeds to light himself on fire. I could effortlessly edit this stuff out and be a good friend, but content. Nightfall sweeps over, and he kills all the mobs that come with it while I look pretty on the sidelines. I mean, I think it's fair enough. I just got that new drip, I don't want to get it all scratched up. He then looks up into the stars, and I didn't know my boy was so deep. For real, do you ever look up into the stars and think maybe someone out there is looking down upon you? Maybe another species who's far more sophisticated than us, and are just monitoring our activity. They'd be like, yo, this modest pelican guy turns his phone volume all the way down, switches off the Bluetooth, and then loads into the incognito section of the Google app every time he takes a shower. What could this mean? Anyway, we find a desert temple and also a mob army. This quickly becomes a great battle between man and monster. I even get involved, which I think is pretty big of me, because now the enchanted armor will have virtually no resale value. During this fight, my girlfriend calls because she said there was some strange men in a white van following her home, and I obviously hang up immediately, because bros don't leave other bros during a great Minecraft battle. Now that I think about it, I haven't heard from her in a couple of days, but massive respect for not leading the strange men back to our house. That would have been a lot to deal with, and as you can see, I'm having a pretty hectic day. We explore the temple and observe how Carbo defuses this bomb so that we don't detonate the TNT, and all get exploded like the innocent villagers from my intro. They had families. This little adventure just keeps getting better as now we find a desert village. We proceed to massacre every single resident that lives here. Nah, I'm kidding. And Carbo just steals a few bits of food, and you can't see it, but I'm currently stealing all of their potted cactuses for my future bedroom, which is debatably worse than a full-on massacre. And Carbo then falls down this huge gorge, which I find highly amusing, as he's the better player. Yet I'm the one standing safely on top of the ravine. We decide to head home, and it's not hard to recognize our island thanks to the huge holy beacon that is eloquently placed on top. I eat some dinner in real life and then come back, and it seems like Will has been up to some serious construction. This is his house, and honestly, it looks pretty damn good, not going to lie. I feel like it's just missing a little something though. There we go, just how females like it. Long and very, very thin, and of course made of dirt. My final surprise for you is my master bedroom, and quite frankly, it's far more aesthetic than Carbo's beachside mansion. Under this family-friendly house of God, we have this dungeon that is heavily decorated with, you guessed it, potted cacti. I've also got myself an altar down here that I stole from the village, so that if I find myself in the unlikely situation where girls have come over and are trying to have premarital lights-off missionary with me, I can simply preach to them until they leave. Stealtho Carbo has his take on this over on his channel, and he's releasing a new video every week. It's great to see. I'll link his YouTube channel in the description. Otherwise, thanks for watching, you absolute legends, and a massive thanks to those who support the channel on Patreon. Until next time, and as always, stay classy.